Hello everyone, welcome back again. So in this presentation we are going to study those amino acid which contains hydroxyl group in their side chain or R group. Okay, again there are three amino acids, and one of those we already learnt in the previous aromatic amino acids. Okay, let me write their name here. Okay. So the first example is serine. Three letter abbreviation is SER. Okay, and threonine, another amino acid is threonine, and the three letter abbreviation is the first three letter itself, TH R, and the one letter abbreviation is T. Here for serine it is S, so no problem with remembering because the first letter itself. And tyrosine we already learnt in the previous under aromatic amino acid, tyrosine, three letter is T Y R, and the one letter is Y. Okay. These three amino acids are hydroxy amino acids. We already learnt about tyrosine. It is belongs to aromatic as well as hydroxy amino acid. Okay, we'll see the structure, how they look like. So let me write the structure of serine first. Okay, so it contains carboxyl group on one side and amino group on another side. There is an hydrogen and the side chain would be like this. Okay, side chain would be like this. It contains CH2 and the hydroxyl group. Okay, and the hydroxyl group. So threonine also looks like this. Okay, contains carboxyl group and amino group and the hydrogen, and the side chain will be like this. Okay, see here there will be hydroxyl group and H and the CH3. Okay, so let me color OH group in red color. Okay, OH group here. Okay, so tyrosine, we already know the structure of tyrosine. C O minus amino group, hydrogen, and we have CH2, and there comes the benzene ring. So there is double bond here, and our benzene ring would be also contains hydroxyl group. Okay, these are the structure of these three amino acids: serine, threonine and tyrosine. Okay, now what are the common things between these? Okay, these three amino acids, they contain hydroxyl group, that is why they are called hydroxy amino acids. Okay, here serine and threonine are both glucogenic amino acids. When their carbon skeleton undergo complete oxidation, they will give glucose, or they will give intermediates of this citric acid, say glucogenic. Even threonine also glucogenic, whereas tyrosine is both glucogenic and ketogenic. So it is both glucogenic and ketogenic. Okay, and all the three amino acids are neutral amino acids. There is no charge in the side chain. Okay, there is no charge here, there is no charge here, they are uncharged. So all the three are neutral amino acids. They are neutral amino acids. Neutral amino acids, all the three, And here only threonine is essential. Threonine is the essential amino acid. So this is essential amino acids. Only threonine must be supplied in our diet. Whereas tyrosine is a non-essential because it can be synthesized from phenylalanine. Even serine is a non-essential amino acid. Non-essential amino acids. That means our body can synthesize serine and tyrosine, but threonine is essential amino acids. And if you take the polarity, both serine and threonine are polar amino acids. You can see they contain hydroxyl group. Okay, so these hydroxyl group can form hydrogen bond with the water. So they like water surface. Okay, both serine and threonine are polar. This is also polar. Okay, tyrosine, because of benzene ring, it is a non-polar amino acid. Even though it contains hydroxyl group, but because of benzene ring, it becomes non-polar. Because of bulky benzene ring, it becomes a non-polar or hydrophobic. Okay. The importance here, tyrosine, we already learned that what is the importance of tyrosine. Serine is one of the important component of what is called phospholipid. Okay. Especially serine. It is a component of phospholipid. There are different types of phospholipid. Okay. So which is present in the brain. This phospholipid which is attached to serine, that specific name of this phospholipid which contains serine is phosphatidyl serine. Phosphatidyl serine, which is present in the brain. Even this serine can be converted to ethanolamine. And this ethanolamine also part of phospholipid. It is called saphaline. Saphaline is also present in the brain. Okay. Both this phosphatidyl serine and saphaline, they are derived from serine. They present in our brain. Okay, that is the importance of serine. So serine, threonine and tyrosine, these three are hydroxy amino acids. Thanks for watching.